Hi guys, welcome back to the Paige for YouTube channel. I am Paige, and if you're new here, a special welcome to you. So in today's video, I'll be giving you a vlog. I'll be taking some x-rays of my friend's teeth and also of Oscar, which is the dummy. So if you'd like to see this, please stay tuned. Today I'm on the clinic at my dental school, and I'll be working with three of my classmates, one of whom has just returned from getting us the x-ray room. Her name is Alyssa. I'll also be working with Kishon and Abigail.
So this is who we'll be working on,
and each of us
will be using knives.
Let's get to work. Firstly, I position the PSP plate on the XCP. I'm shaking the PSP so that it moves down in the sleeve, allowing me to bend the sleeve and prevent the PSP from falling off the XCP. The PSP plate is used for capturing the image of the tooth being exposed to radiation, while the XCP is used for holding the PSP in place. After positioning the plate, I'll place the film behind the tooth of interest and close the mannequin's mouth so that it is secured. Next was to position the tube head that produces the x-ray in line with the ring of the XCP. We then leave the x-ray room and turn on the x-ray machine. So we've just x-rayed the right posterior teeth on the mandibular arch. Now we're going to repeat the process, gradually moving from the right to the left side of the mandibular arch. You may notice that I was working with the yellow XCP, and now Kishon is working with the blue XCP. No, this is not just a matter of preference, but XCP instruments are color-coded for easier assembly. Red instruments are for taking batwing radiographs, yellow for taking posterior radiographs, and blue for taking anterior radiographs.
The process in the room.
As Kishon said, we're now in the processing room. This is where we place the PSP plate in a PSP plate scanner. This scans the image on the plate and it is shown on the computer. I then arrange them in anatomical order of the dental arch.
So we need one video of this.
Guys, it's coming on the screen. Kiss on it, look at the better man.
Yeah. Did you hold it?
Putting that on.
So the first x-ray to be processed is of the mandibular canine and premolars. And now we can mount it. So we start with an empty canvas, and soon enough it becomes a not so empty canvas. And after a few more scans and mounts, we have a full canvas. So what we're looking at is a complete radiograph of the dental arches. From the top, we have the maxillary molars and premolars, then the maxillary lateral incisor and canine, followed by the maxillary central incisors, then the left maxillary lateral incisor and canine. We then move on to the molars and the premolars. Moving down, we have the mandibular molars and premolars. On the right side, we have the molars and premolars as well. Lastly, we have the batwing radiographs in the middle, showing the crown of the maxillary and mandibular molars and premolars. And that is how the radiographs are taken and mounted.
We got arm sleeves.
More?
Yeah, so we gave you guys back one.